Hey, what's up, guys? If you're using Thunderbird email client application and you had changed your computer, upgraded your computer to another one, and you like to move all your profiles and email and all the data along with this to the new computer, so stick around. In this video, I will show you how to backup and restore your email application Thunderbird, and all the data belongs to your older email and all your profile settings, even your passwords included with that. My name is Mazhar, and at RightSolutions, I create tutorials for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's head to the computer number one, where you are going to take all this data to the new computer. So here we are in the computer number one. From this computer, we are going to export multiple email accounts. I got about 10 accounts in this computer here, and all the data to the new computer. So what do you need with this to just move your data? Of course, you need a device, or maybe any cloud service. USB is very handy if you have a USB. And mind you, if you have multiple accounts, so your data might will be a little more. So just take something around 8 or 16 GB of a stick. You can also use Google Drive to copy your data there, or maybe Drive One. So whatever the source is available for you, you can just use it. We'll use a USB drive here. So let's go and start our application here. So just go onto the start button here. Let's start Thunderbird here. And it takes a few seconds to start, depending on the speed of your system. So as soon your Thunderbird application comes in, so first thing what you need to do is just to make sure that your application is updated. And yeah, of course, it's downloading my new emails here. So as I said, I got about 10 email accounts here. So before we go further, let's go and click on help here and just go down on to the about Thunderbird. And let's see what version are we using. So here we are using my computer has a 102.7.2 version, and there is an update available 102.8.0. So I will not update in this computer. I will update into the new computer. Maybe I will fresh install. And if you are also installing it, so you could also fresh install it. So let's go and close it up. And now here go back to the top menus here and click on tools. And from these tools, you will find the menu export, click on it, and it will bring up this export page for you. And you can just see that it has already an option which is available to export, but there is a caution at the bottom. If your current profile is larger than 2 GB, we suggest you back it up by yourself. So that means in my case, I do have 10 accounts in this, so I'm very sure that it is going to be more than 2 GB. So let's go, and I suggest you do the same way. So let's go and look at this open profile folder here. So you can just simply click on it, and here your profile folder is opened. So now from here, just to be very careful, we have to just go on to the right arrow here on the top, and we need to go one level up, and then again click second time, and we need to go two levels up, and now one more, and click again, and here we are three levels up. And you can see that you are here into the roaming folder. So just make sure that you are not in any other folder. So we are in the roaming folder, and in this roaming folder you will find a folder Thunderbird. So this is the folder what we need actually, which is carrying all the data, all your profile settings and everything here, even your passwords. So just go right click on this, and you can copy it. And at the same time, you can also use Control C to copy it. And now for copying, just let's go and insert the USB drive here, and now click on this PC and click on this drive which we just inserted, and just Control V, right click, maybe just paste it anywhere here. Just wait till the data is completely copied. Okay, so here, this is the first part done. So you are done with this computer. So now you can just simply close it, and you could have closed the Thunderbird application as well. So now let's head to the computer number two here. So this is the computer number two. You can say the destination PC. We are going to import all these copied accounts data into this computer here. So now because it's fresh installed, so I don't have Thunderbird installs here. So you can, if you have already installed, so you can just skip the installation. But If you are also doing the fresh installation, so just go open Google Chrome here, the first search engine, and just type here Thunderbird, download Thunderbird. So you can just see the most probably the first option will be the Thunderbird website. So I just click on it, and now you can see a big green button here saying free download. Just click on it, and here your download starts. So now. At the same time, of course, you know, these guys are doing a very good job. So if you like to donate them, you could actually donate it. And if you don't want to, you can just go and click it on the right top button here. So it will close it up. And now I think your application is downloaded. So just click on this Thunderbird setup file here. And here it's extracting the files. And here you hear that you will get this pop-up and just allow this to do whatever it wants to. So now the application is started up to install, and here you can just have the welcome screen and just click on to the next and now go with the standard setup. In this next window here, it just suggests you to use Thunderbird as my default email. I use the Thunderbird as a secondary application. I have another application where I have all my email accounts, so I will just uncheck it. If you just want to keep this as a default, you can just leave it checked. So just click on install, and you can see that your installation will just take a few seconds. And here we are. There is a check mark on launch Mozilla Thunderbird now. So just let it be checked and start Mozilla to just make sure that it's properly installed. So let's say that here we see that the application has installed completely. You can just see the application is here, and now don't create any accounts here. So we are going to import it, so we don't need to create any accounts. So just go click this button and close this application here. And I believe we also don't need this browser here. So you can just click this and close it as well. So we need to find that roaming folder. We could go the same route that we took, but let's see from the Windows Explorer. So just open Windows Explorer, and from my PC, just click the local hard disk C. And from here in the local hard disk C, you will find some folders here. So look for the folders named users. Just click open it up, and now my user is Mazhar, so I will open this one. So you find your user, so just click on that user here and open this user folder. And now from this user folder you will find a folder called app data. So just open this app data folder here, just click on it, and now here this is the roaming folder. Open it up here. This is the folder where we're going to bring our data. So to get our data from our USB, so just go insert your USB drive into the computer here. And here it is. Now just go and open this, this drive, and this is the Thunderbird folder. Just click on it and Control C, or maybe right click, and just copy it up. And now just go back to the, which is the roaming folder here. So just go and right click anywhere, or maybe just simply press Control V to paste it here. And let's see, just wait. Okay, we are almost here, and now you can see it is prompting you to replace the files in the destination folder. So just a click on replace the files here, and it will overwrite all the files, and copying is completed. So now you can close this one here, and I think now is the time to just launch your application. So just click on the start button here, and just you can just launch Thunderbird from here. Yes, okay, click here. So start the application. And here you can see that our application is on the same page, on the same screen where we actually last time copied the data from. So you can just simply go and click and close this export page here. So you can just say simply click on get new messages, and you might will hear, yeah, you can see that it's fetching the new messages from the server. So it shows that our import is successful, but to just make sure that even it will send the emails. So let's go and test one of my temporary accounts, which I just use for the junk mail around. So just let's open this one from this here. So just click on the right and just type my same email address here, and in subject say testing new email, and send it out. Just let's say hi, and now you can just click send, and let's see, it's a sending message. So my message is sent. So now let's go and click again on to get messages, and see if we receive this message back. So here it is. So you can just see that test new message has been received in the same email account where we actually sent. So that shows that your email accounts had been completely imported. All your profile settings and all your passwords are intact, and you can just continue where you left work in the old machine. I hope this video added some help to your migrating of this application. If you think it did, don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will see you with some other video soon. So you have a great day.